Okay, the first question would be, would the 20-year-old you ever see yourself being a member of the Flower Kings?
When I was 20 years old, the Flower Kings is what I listened to most of the time, mostly for inspiration. They were just my favorite band. And all I could hope for was to get to see them play live. And luckily I got to, because I was studying abroad in Greece and The Sum of No Evil just came out, and I got to see them play in Rome. And leaving that show, I felt like one day I'd like to be in a band like that, but never did it cross my mind that I would actually be in the band someday. So it's really a dream come true for me.
Do you ever get nerdy and start looking into synthesizers online, like old synthesizers, strange, different synthesizers, with the urge to buy any of them?
Every once in a while, I'll take a look at some things, but I try my best to not tempt myself to buy anything because between my keyboards and my software, I already have a very large palette of sounds to work with. I would absolutely love to have a real Hammond and Leslie someday, but it's a little too loud for my apartment right now. So someday, I'll look into getting some new toys.
How did you get drawn into playing, recording, and writing music in the first place? Even before the Flower Kings, of course.
I guess what got me started was growing up, my parents really loved music, and there was a lot of instruments around the house. My dad had a Juno 106, a couple of guitars, and we had an upright piano. And around 3 years old, I quickly figured out that I liked trying to play things on the piano by ear. And so that just kind of snowballed into me wanting to just continue to learn everything I can about music and join all of the different music programs that my schools were offering throughout all the years. I was playing in different bands, and I was just always inspired by it. So I think just between my own personal motivation and also getting good feedback from others just kind of kept me on that path.
How does your formal music training help you in the Flower Kings or elsewhere in modern music? Recording, playing on stage, etc., etc.
Whether it's formal music training or just experience playing in other bands and trying to compose things, I attribute all of that to being helpful in any scenario that I'm in. So I think the biggest thing that my formal education gave me was an ability to analyze what I'm doing and have a better way of communicating to other musicians what it is that I'm trying to do. So just understanding the universal language that most musicians are going to speak, I think that helps me convey a music idea more. But I think that all experiences are helpful, and it's kind of hard to know when you're doing anything with music where you're pulling that skill from. It all kind of meshes together. But I definitely learned a lot with my formal education.
What are the benefits of being in a band compared to doing things your own way or recording yourself or just making music on your own?
Mostly because you get different perspective. Everybody comes from different backgrounds and has their own voice on their instruments. So as you're working on a piece of music, what's great is you can't predict everything. You can put a certain idea forward, but then you get all these great surprises and different perspectives that come in. So it's a very fun and exciting way to see the music develop. And it's also just great to be a part of a team that's working on all of this music together and then going out and playing it live. So that becomes a great celebration, and it's especially playing this music live that you've bonded over, that you've been building together, makes it extra rewarding. So I absolutely love being in a band.
How did you discover the Flower Kings, and what song was that?
I first heard of the Flower Kings, I think it was around 2006. My friend Matt Graff showed me Retropolis, and then he showed me The Truth Will Set You Free, and I was absolutely blown away, and I dug into all of the Flower Kings albums, and it's all I really wanted to listen to for a long time. It, for road trips especially, I put it on all Flower Kings albums, and that would last the whole road trip.
You studied classical composition at Berkeley. Any plans to write for any orchestras in the future?
Absolutely. Writing for full orchestra is a huge interest of mine. And it takes a lot of time, but it's so worth it because it's so dynamic and textural and so beautiful. So I would really, really love to write some more music for the orchestra whenever I can.
Tell us about the first encounter with me and Roine in Lund like 15 years ago. What was that?
So the reason that I went to Lund, Sweden was to record the first self-titled album for my band, Enema Sporadic. I actually found Roine on MySpace, sent him a message to see if he would produce our next record, and to my great surprise, he said that he had time to do that and that we could record at Jonas's studio and that Jonas would play bass. So we flew over there, we stayed at this really cool hostel that is an old train. It was just called The Train, and it was just absolutely a dream come true for me to get to be in the studio with those guys and just feel like I was in such good hands. I mean, to me, like, these are the prog masters, and as long as I came to that studio with some decent ideas, what could possibly go wrong? So I think it was very successful. We made a very good record that I'm proud of, but mostly I'm just proud that I forged this relationship with Roine and Jonas, and here I am today. Now I'm in the Flower Kings. So I think that it was a really, really smart decision for us to work with them back then.
Have you ever written music for vocals?
I haven't written for vocals. For some reason, my imagination rarely goes there. In fact, even music that I listen to that has vocals and I hear it all the time, I hardly remember the lyrics just because my ear is mostly drawn to the other elements of what's happening in the recording. So I think just kind of naturally, I just gravitate to trying to do things instrumentally. But it's something that I definitely want to explore trying. I don't really know what I'm made of with the vocals. So it's definitely something worth exploring.
If you could pick just one musician to make music with, who would that be?
My favorite musician is film composer John Williams.
...30 minutes before the premiere gig with the Flower Kings in Sao Paulo, Brazil.
I was very nervous and very excited at the same time, and that 30 minutes was a very slow, slow 30 minutes. I was watching every minute pass and just so worried about if I go out onto the stage, what will the keyboard sound like? Will I be able to play? Will I remember what I've learned? And how will the audience respond to what I'm doing? But as soon as we walked out and I saw the faces of the audience and they all seemed very welcoming and were just excited to see us, as soon as we started playing, everything just kind of felt very natural, actually, and I had a lot of fun. So it was great.
Could you see it coming 15 years ago that you would become a member of a Swedish prog band?
15 years ago, I thought, you know, maybe I'd be in a touring band in the US, but I never thought that I would meet anybody from Sweden and actually be in a Swedish band where I fly over and I play shows in Europe. I never would have thought that that was possible.
I have a feeling you like movies a lot. Do you have any talent for acting? Have you ever tried it?
I do love movies, but my interest has always been to write music for them, so acting hasn't really crossed my mind before. But that's an interesting thought.
Next five questions, gentlemen, are for Mr. Z. Kemis. Number one chord that represents you.
This is the opening chord of an Endless Sporadic self-titled album where I first met Roina and Jonas.
If you were a symbol, which one they will be and why?
I think I'd be a ride because of its versatility, and maybe I wouldn't be hit quite as hard.
If you had to listen just one song in loop for 3 years, which one they will be?
3 years is a lot of time for one piece of music. I fear that I would start to hate that piece of music. So I choose John Cage, 4 minutes and 33 seconds of silence, so that way I can think of music instead of be stuck listening to one piece over and over and over and over and over and over.
Question number four. Will you ever match your pants with your fantastic jackets and shirt? Will you?
Only Roina can do that.
Why you never bring me roses? Why not?
The next time that we play live, I will bring you roses in the middle of the show.